Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Prince George's Community College Center for Performing Arts Grand Theater. My name is Richard Anatone. I'm a professor of music here, and I'd like to thank you all for joining us today for our second guest artist performance. Today's group will be Clarinet and Friends. It is a DC-based clarinet trio featuring clarinet, piano, and violin. And so, without any further delay, please welcome Clarinet and Friends.
Darius Mio, like Francis Poulenc, was a member of the French Six. That was a group of six composers. And I think the name was created by a publicist because the six composers really didn't have that much in common musically. They were all composers, but they had very different styles. This piece, suite for violin, clarinet, and piano, I think of it as very playful, like children playing, except the fourth movement, which reminds me again of a Hollywood movie with, you know, 1930s jazz and melodrama. And one thing that both of these composers, Poulenc and Mio, have in common is that they change the emotion of the music just like that. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. It's great to be here. The piece we are about to perform is Dance Macabre by Saint-Saëns. Mr. Saint-Saëns originally intended this piece as an art song first, voice and piano, based on the poem by Henri Cazalès. The poem was about French superstition, but later he changed his mind and transcribed to tone poem for orchestra. This particular version we are performing is for violin and piano, better known as Halloween music. Lots of tritones and spooky mood. I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Francis Poulenc had a very interesting life. He was born in 1899 to a wealthy family of drug makers. And he lived a very privileged life. In the 1920s, he moved to Paris and was part of the very vibrant art scene in Paris at that time. His music embodies a lot of sarcasm and satire. And also, interestingly enough, Poulenc was extremely religious, a very religious Catholic. At the same time, he found out that he was gay. So that kind of dichotomy in his life really influences music, I think. And especially in the second movement of this piece, you hear that, to me, a very spiritual, almost reminds you of cathedral music. And the third movement is so contrasty, like one moment it's happy, another moment it's sad, exciting. And I think the third movement embodies a lot of jazz ideas from the 1960s. This piece was premiered by Benny Goodman on clarinet and Leonard Bernstein playing piano.
Thank you.
Aaron Khachaturian is the only composer on this program that's not French. He's Armenian. But he was, back in the old Soviet Union days, he was considered a Soviet composer. But this piece really uses folk music from Armenia. It sounds very improvisatory. In a way, it reminds me a little bit of Contrast by Bartok for the same instrumentation, in the sense that it takes music of the folk, of like the regular people, and uses it for classical music.